Gentlemen, welcome back to the TJ Hanley Starting a Business, Building a Brand vlog. This one, big number, 219. So if you missed last vlog with all those amazing entrepreneurs, content creators, if you missed that vlog, gentlemen, I don't know what to tell you. You need to stop this one right now and go watch it. Or you can watch this one first, but then you got to make sure you go back. There is so much amazing advice that these entrepreneurs are dropping on us and you. It is ridiculous. When I, seriously, it's not often that I'm stunned, but I watched that vlog literally probably 6 times because the advice that each, and that's the crazy thing. Nobody knew what the other person was saying. Nobody had I talked about this, so this will be my tip. They all came up with different things, which I thought was amazing. And it really just, that vlog, I'm telling you guys, in terms of quality content and amazing entrepreneurial advice, guys, it really doesn't get any better than that vlog, in my opinion. Next vlog might be all right if I can actually make it happen. So here's something cool that's going down, like it's actually happening tomorrow. But anyway, I couldn't work it out with, anyway, I wasn't sure that he was gonna say yes. So here's the deal. I am tomorrow going to film a few videos with none other than Mr. Kevin O'Leary, aka Mr. Wonderful, aka Mr. Shark Tank, aka Mr. He hated this idea. He also, I think, hated the Pete and Pedro or Mini Donkey idea, but we're gonna talk about that hopefully tomorrow in more detail. So, really cool opportunity. I was asked by his team if I'd be interested in being a guest on his Ask Mr. Wonderful podcast, not podcast, it's like YouTube channel. Kevin O'Leary started a YouTube channel. He's got 100,000 subscribers already, which I think is really cool. And the business advice that he is offering is also amazing. I'll link to his YouTube channel down below. But I was asked if I would be interested in going on his channel and being a guest on this Ask Mr. Wonderful YouTube video series. And I'm like, hell yeah. But I was asked a few months ago, and then I didn't hear anything from them. And then just last week, I got an email from one of his assistants or the person that helps him. And she was like, hey, we're gonna be in Atlanta. Are you interested or free in filming this? And I'm like, absolutely. And so when I said yes, I also went to them with another idea. I said, I want to do another video with Kevin, if he would be open to it, if he'd be cool, with me giving him a bad boy Alpha M makeover. And so she's like, let me check, and went back to him, and he's like, yeah, let's do this. And so tomorrow, I'm going down. Christian is coming. Shit. It's my YouTube rep. When your YouTube rep calls, you gotta take the call. I had a question about the algorithm because something funky has happened. And anyway, what was I talking about? I was talking about Kevin O'Leary. So fast forward, I'm going tomorrow. Christian, we're gonna film some videos. I'm gonna give him a makeover. He said yes. We're gonna have some fun, and I cannot wait. And so I was planning on filming a vlog tomorrow, and thinking, okay, I'm gonna get him, and amazing, right? An amazing opportunity to get a serious entrepreneur. I think he sold his one company, The Learning Company, for billions of dollars. He's done a lot. And honestly, I think that he, a lot of people are he's a jerk, right? He's, honestly, when you watch Shark Tank, and I will go back on the record again and say Shark Tank is one of the greatest shows ever. And if you're an entrepreneur and you're not watching Shark Tank, you are missing out on an incredible learning experience, because regardless of if the business or the ideas are crap, the insight behind the questions that the sharks will ask, and then just it's amazing just to watch smart people. In my opinion, everybody that goes on Shark Tank is smart, right? Or at least they're let's put it this, they're willing to take a chance and they're swinging the bat. And if I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. You got to be willing to swing the bat in order to hit a home run. And if you're an entrepreneur, you got to swing the bat. The reason why a lot of people don't succeed is because they never try. And everybody on Shark Tank, damn it, regardless of if their product sucks, their idea is terrible, they need better family and friends to actually be like, yo, that sucks, right? They are swinging the bat. And that, in my opinion, gets props. The other cool thing, just little Shark Tank insight, the thing that I took away from Shark Tank was how smart all the other entrepreneurs were that I met. All the entrepreneurs, for half the season, will stay at a hotel, and then they just film for like days on end. They basically will film like 8 to 10 like pitches in a day. And it's really amazing how they crank that stuff out. But anyway, isn't about Shark Tank. I'm hoping that I can film tomorrow the Teach Hanley vlog 220 tomorrow with Kevin. If time allows, I'm sure he'll be like, yeah, sure, no problem, because he is trying to build his brand on this platform, which I think is pretty cool. Anyway, something else that's really cool, more about that later, is this right here. I'm going to open it up. It is the Scrub Body Bar. We told you about this, right? So, like I said, we have launched now 2 bars. The first one is the Wash Body Bar. This is the Scrub Body Bar. The scent is stronger than the Wash Body Bar. It's just, it's sexy. It's kind of like sandalwoody, I think. Very masculine, but not too like overpowering. The scent also does not linger on your body. This bad boy is an exfoliation like madman. When I use this thing, right, it's like, yeah, like it's serious exfoliation. The Wash Body Bar, it's not like super exfoliating. It's a little bit, you feel it, there's some stuff in there to make it like a little bit exfoliating. But this bad boy, my God, look out, it'll take nipples off. They say, or we say, that you should only use this like twice a week and then use the Wash Bar like every other time. But I've been using this like every day, twice a day, for the past like 2 weeks, and I love it. I love it that much. And if you don't press super hard, it's okay. But my skin, super soft, incredible. Guys, this can be accessed on your dashboard if you guys want to add this to your box. So something else I want to tell you, a little update on Teej Hanley. We are changing things. We are changing things up. Fundamentally, we are changing our business a little bit. I'll tell you more about that later. Because we are still flushing things out and figuring out how it's changing, because there are a lot of things that we need to sort of tweak in order to roll out this new sort of like idea. And really it boils down to us wanting you to get what you want when you want it and not trying to force people into something that we feel you should be doing. I know that was cryptic. I know that was weird. But I'm just letting you know that we are constantly looking and tweaking and changing and making sure that Teej Hanley is the best company and the best products and service for you. It's not about us. And I think that that's one of the issues or downsides that we fell into or faced early on for the first 3.5 years, is that we were trying to force people into these 3 like boxes, like 1, 2, or 3, you're either using this or you can't buy anything from us. Like that's it. And how crazy is that, right? Everybody who tries Teej Hanley loves Teej Hanley. They love the products, like period. The products are amazing. But unless you're interested in level 1, level 2, level 3, you can't buy anything from us. Nope, we are saying no. Your money's no good because we want it our way. We want you to use Teej the way we want you to use Teej. And it's a hard thing to swallow to realize that you might not be right. So it's part of the process. It's learning, right? And now here's the upside. The upside to what we've done is that we really have focused all around the system. And we're not getting around the system aspect of things. It's still going to be like system. But what constitutes a system? Maybe changing a little bit in the future, this year. The good news is that we were able to build an incredibly successful business, very successful business. We continue to grow. We continue to be, you know, very profitable. But when you look at how many people we acquired last year in terms of the volume of customers that we brought in and the net that we retained, there's something wrong. In order for us to get to X number of like total subscribers, we would need to like it. Something's wrong. There's a problem. There's a fundamental problem with the way that we're doing something. And so we've really been doubling down on trying to explore and talk to you guys, the customers, and doing a lot of outreach just to figure out, okay, what do you want and how can we help? How can we get out of our own way and let you basically dictate to some degree. Now, I know that a lot of you are like, yo, we just want to buy like a 27-ounce tube of wash. Why can't I do that? That's probably not going to happen. But there are some things that we can do and some things that we can tweak from a Tiege customer perspective and experience that can make a big difference. And I know this is cryptic. It'll make more sense once we sort of flush things out. The next quarterly meeting, this is really what we're talking about. We're diving deeper into these fundamental things that we want to change, that we want to modify, that we want to do at Tiege Hanley, and that we feel will make a dramatic impact. Like, because let me tell you something. If we figure out just a little bit, like tweak something, and it actually, like, we're talking about a company that is growing fast to a company that is going to go like out of control amazingly fast. And I really feel like we can do that. And we have the team. There are some things that we need to do in order to make sure that we can continue to support the growth, because some of the fulfillment is going to have to change. It used to be real simple, right? You just, you know, pre-package level one, level two, level three, have them on the shelf, right? And then, oh, I got 3,700, you know, level ones to ship today. You go pull 3,700 boxes of Tiege Hanley, level one, domestic, boom, slap your label on, boom, you ship them out. Next, level two, 2,200. Boom, you pull 2,200 Tiege level. And I'm not saying those are the numbers. I'm just giving you an example. It was easy. We could pre-pack all the boxes. But now, with the addition of additional products and what we're thinking about allowing people to customize their system a bit more, there's a lot more complexity when it comes to the fulfillment end of things. And so those are all things that we got to figure out from a company perspective, a staffing perspective, a fulfillment perspective, and a shipping perspective. And those are all things that we're working on. But I just wanted to let you guys know that because it's a big deal and we want to be better and we know that we can be. And so I just wanted to give you a little FYI. But gentlemen, now let's dive into those business questions. There are a few, not many, but a few. So first business question comes from our friend Kadar Awad. He says, why do you think the Alpha M style system, for the record, last one in existence, I think. it's a classic. It's vintage. Anyway, why do you think the Alpha M style system failed on Shark Tank? And this is so funny. I'm seeing Kevin. I could ask him. Actually, I won't ask him because I think I know the answer. If it had not been so expensive, do you think it would have sold better? So pricing is one of those things that regardless of what you're selling, you really need to sort of test and dial things in. And when I created the Alpha M style system, this was like my first like official like jump into the information product world. A lot of my friends like Antonio and some of these other guys were already like in the info product world. And so I sort of took their lead in terms of, you know, pricing. And in that world, you price things a little bit higher. Like $297 for information product is not outrageous. Now, that being said, the platform or the method I chose to deliver the information, this like download, this actual like disk that you put into your computer and you actually play, this was why partially why the Alpha M style system didn't do so well on Shark Tank. Yes, the price was crazy, but the truth is the sharks don't have any concept. At least back then they didn't on info products, and like $297 was not like outside of the realm of reasonable back then, and it still is. I mean, there are a lot of info products that you're not doing anything other than like getting a downloadable link that's like $1,000, $2,000, $5,000. Like the price goes like up, and the truth is, if you're solving a problem and it's a real problem, people will pay good money for you to solve that problem for them and for their answers to be, or for their questions to be answered. And so that's what I thought I was doing with this. I thought I was solving a problem. Guys don't know what to wear. I basically simplified it with a simple style equation. And I thought it was a great idea. I still think it's a great idea, to be completely honest. But if I had it to do over, I would make it obviously not something like CDs that you ship people. I would make it obviously an e-product that I could just download or send somebody electronically, and I would probably charge a little bit less. I think that if I revamped this, made it, you know, $49, $99 or whatever it is, make it better, I think I could probably sell a lot of it, but the truth is, in order to sell anything, you've got to push it. You've got to really like get behind it. And I'm just, you know, it's like, okay, that was fun, you know, but it just wasn't something I wanted to continue to push. I don't love e-products personally, but I know a lot of you guys do, and they're definitely, you're able to make a lot of money. I've got a friend, just to throw it out there, I've got a friend who sold $1 million worth of his e-product in December, $1 million. Now, he spent like $500,000 or $600,000 in like marketing and like ads for like Facebook and stuff, but he generated $1 million from like a $49, $59 e-product. And so if it solves a problem, people will pay and people will buy, but it's about identifying what problem you're solving and really going after it. This was a problem, I didn't solve it properly. I hope that answers your question. Next business question comes from our friend Muhammad Ali. What advice can you give me on selecting my brand name? Example, the domain is figure. I'm not sure what that means. Instagram name is already taken. So in terms of your brand name, it's really, I don't know. That's a really hard question to answer because, you know, you used to think that like, oh, the brand name needs to be like super solid. You need to understand what it is. Like that's the way you're going to, you know, ultimately be successful. I mean, Tiege Hanley, right? That was kind of a weird name, right? And nobody knows what a Tiege Hanley is. You know, Google, Uber. Like you can think of all these examples of businesses that have these names that are just weird and have nothing to do with what they're selling or what they're doing, but they made it work. I really feel like it's more about the marketing. And so getting hung up on a name specifically and then like an Instagram name, like I think it's better, like if we were to do like Tiege, right? I think if we were to try to do like, you know, skincare.tiege. Like it's too much, right? I think that you should try and find a name that is short, a URL that's available, and just rock it. Picking a name, that's the fun part, right? Oh, it's fun to think about it and to sit there and go to GoDaddy and search for domains and things of that nature. That's the fun part. But the truth is, a brand name isn't going to make or break a business. It's all about you and execution. It's about marketing, because I've also said this. Actually, perfect example. There is a dude who has shown up to my office 2 times unannounced. Each time he shows up, I'm like, oh God, it's this dude again, right? He's got this invention for like a phone, right? And it's a really cool invention. It's really great. It's probably, you know, the best invention of its kind for the phone. But he has no marketing. He has no sales channel. And so unless somebody takes that and runs with it, it's going to be the best product that nobody's heard of. It really boils down, like I said, to execution and marketing. Honestly, marketing and execution. Those two things, gentlemen, figure them out. If you can get those things together and working, gentlemen, it doesn't matter what you call it. It's going to work because you're amazing. Guys, that's where we're going to wrap things up. Down in the comments, if you've got a business question, please ask it. Now, I'm going to be hopefully filming next vlog tomorrow with Mr. O'Leary. And so I'm not going to be able to ask him your questions, but that's all right. No problem. The following week, me. I got you. Something else that Tiege has is the Scrub Body Bar. Guys, if you want to check this out, like I said, take it easy on the sensitive areas because it can definitely do some damage. Guys, remember, we love you more than our double monk strap shoes. And at Tiege Hanley, it is all about you, period. And that is the reason why Tiege is mixing things up internally, because we want to do a better job at giving you what you want when you want it, period.